Hi there, Stuart Shields here for Guitar Interactive magazine, and today I am looking at this very beautiful, delicious JV60 from Sterling by Musicman. Now this is the James Valentine Signature model, and I must mention this is the counterpart to the full Musicman model. This is a very affordable, excellent, well-built, I love this guitar, version of the counterpart of the Musicman model. For those of you who don't know, James Valentine is the axe slinger in Maroon 5. Now, whether you're a fan of this guy, the band, doesn't matter. This is an amazing guitar, very well built, excellent for the price point. And we're going to start off as usual, top to bottom. At the top, we've got this typical Musicman 4/2 headstock. Now, if we have a look at the back here, these wonderful locking tuners. We've got a compensated nut as well for tuning stability. And turning it over, hopefully the cameras will pick this up, we get to the first main selling point of this guitar. This is incredible. We have an oil and wax rubbed roasted maple neck. Now this is very on trend. There's quite a few models that utilize this finish. Very, very popular at the moment, but I've seen very few that do this for the price point that we have here. A big fan of the Musicman Cutlass, and that is a great wedge-shaped Musicman with this roasted maple neck. I've not seen this on any of the Musicman guitars, particularly the Sterlings, for this price point. Really, really cool. Very smooth, very easy to play. We've also got, on the front here, we're looking at a roasted maple fingerboard. Radius, if you're interested in, is 9.5 for this. Stainless steel frets, 22 frets. And then moving down to the body, this is very cool. And again, the finish on this, we're looking at a translucent buttermilk finish. And you can just see through this, it's delicious. It looks like a great big sweet. I love it. If we look very hard at the finish, you can actually see the grain through the wood. Hopefully the cameras will pick this up. This is sustainable Mississippi swamp ash. And you can really feel this with the weight and the balance. Now, getting onto the money stuff, here's where it's really cool. What we've got here is, it looks like two humbuckers, and this isn't. We've got a humbucker in the neck, and then in the bridge, this is actually a single coil in a humbucker style casing. And this gives us that very, you can see it's angled, it's very much that Telecaster type tone and look. So having a quick listen to this on a clean channel, we'll run through the three pickup selectors, and we have in the bridge the Tele pickup. Then our three-way is a split between the two. And then a humbucker in the neck. Okay, onto our next great feature of this guitar. This also has a push-push, not to be confused with push-pull, 12 dB volume boost, and this is in the volume pot. So down we have, pushing in gives us a 12 dB boost. And this is powered by a 9-volt battery on the back here. We'll open up the casing so you can see. And this is an active circuit, really useful if we want to get that kind of breaking clean tone, give us a bit more headroom, a bit more hair on an already driven channel. A couple of more things I want to look at here. Aesthetically as well, design-wise, we've got this wonderful turtle scratch plate. And keeping with this mix of vintage and modern looks, we've got this wonderful vintage bridge here with the bent saddles. And this is a great looking guitar, thoroughly mixing modern and contemporary looks. Playability, design, love this guitar. As per usual, you can check out a full review, full spec and details in the magazine. For now, Sterling, Music Man, great work. James Valentine, if I see you, I'm going to give you a big handshake. Good work on the guitar. I'll see you next time. Bye for now.